How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. So in the last videos, we've got this far with our base. We need to do cylinder porting off of this surface, and we'll put some letters on, and we'll make it some colors. So let's start with the hardest thing first, and that's the cylinder porting. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw some referencing lines first. So we're going to make a sketch on this surface. And we're just going to right click, of course, create sketch, as we do all the time. And we're just going to draw some lines. So there's a line that goes here. Another line here. Another line here. Now, I don't really need all these lines, but I'm going to draw them anyway, just to it gives you a little more idea of what we're doing. So now I'm going to make them all construction lines. I'm just going to select them and hit X to turn them into construction lines. Now we're going to dimension them. Okay, so these are, this will be 1 inch apart. This will be 0.22 inches apart. This line here will be, just click the edge of that to select this, and we'll select the center, will be 0.5. And this edge, this one to the center there, will be 0.11. Now, I could have used the symmetry command to do all this also, but it was just easier to do it this way. Now I'm going to draw some circles at these intersections. Okay. Right there. 0.09935. That's the size of the hole that we're going to be drilling. Now this is a nice command here. I need to have three more holes. I could do this probably a little bit quicker if I would use the rectangular pattern command. Now there's actually two objects here. There's a circle and there's a point. It looks like it's the same thing, but it's not. It's two things. There's a point and we'll select and the circle. So up here it says 2 selected. Then we're going to down here to the direction. Well, I want to go this way, right? And it shows 3, and that shows 3, right? So I'm going to do 2, and I'm going to do 1 inch. That's fine. And then I'm going to come down. But I only want 2. Now I'm counting, it counts the one that you started with, so that's why it's 2. And the distance is 0.22. See, now I have 4 circles in the right spots. Say OK. And they're dashed, and so they're construction circles. Okay. Now I've located where the port needs to end up, is what I've done. We'll say stop. Now I didn't really need to do all that, but it really helps understand a little more what's going on. Now we need to have an angled hole from here up to that port. Same with this one, and this one's go down to this port. It's 30 degrees. So what we need to do is, there's no surface to select on. We need to create a plane, since we have to make our sketches on planes and surfaces. So we're going to go up here to construct and plane angle at an angle right there. We're going to select that. Now we select, it says line. We have a construction line. We're going to select this construction line. If you turn it on end, it's kind of hard to see, but if you leave it at an angle, it's a little harder, easier to tell what you're doing. We're going to rotate that, grab that little circle, and we're going to rotate it to the angle we want it to be at. Or we can go over here and type it in. We want it at 120, and I just turned it till it was said 120. Boom. Now I have a plane. Now we're going to construct another plane on the other line. Select the line. You can see how I'm selecting the line. And we're going to turn that one to 60 degrees. There we go. See, now I have this nice X, and you can see that if I drew a circle on this plane here, it would go up to that hole. And if I drew a circle on this one, it would go down to that hole. So we're going to just go, we're going to go create sketch again. We're going to select the plane. We're going to say create sketch. Now it turns it normal to us, so the model looks funny. We're going to draw some more holes. And we're just going to go and say right there on the center of this hole. Now if you zoom in really good, you can really get it accurate. Right? There. And then we're going to do the same thing over here. Now we have those two ports, right? Stop, sketch. Turn it a little bit, you can see how that's an angled disc. We can go to extrude, select this disc and this disc. So we have both of them. It's going to be a cut. And we're going to change it to two-sided also. And we're going to grab the front one and we'll pull it out a little bit and turn it on the side, and we can drag it right up into that hole. Boom. Now we have two ports, and you can see how did we end up with our alignment. You can take a look at it. You can see how your port is, of course, going to be not round anymore. It's going to be an oval hole, but did it center up on our circle, and it's centered on our point. So we hit it dead on, right where we want it to be. Okay, that works out pretty good. Now that's why I didn't have to draw all this other stuff, but it really gives you an idea what you were doing, and it's more of a demonstration thing. I could have just placed those points there, and drew the circles, and I didn't have to draw all the lines and everything. But the lines really help out a lot. So now we're going to select this one, create sketch, and do the same thing. Circles. There we go. Stop sketch, do an extrude, and we're going to select that circle and this circle. And we're going to say two-sided, and it's going to be a cut. And we're going to pull it out a little bit out here, and do it this way, and drag that right on down. There. Now we have all our ports put in. We can turn off that sketch. Now here's a nice little feature. We'll go up here, click on base, opacity control, make it, I don't know, 30, sometimes 40%, whatever one you want. And you can see your ports. Oops. You can see how you did. The ports go right where we want them from, and they go right up into the upper and lower ports. And did we drill deep enough? We drilled fine. We could always shorten that up a little bit if we wanted to. 1 3/8 would be fine. I think we're good. Now we're going to go back, take our opacity back to 100, and there we go. All right, letters. Select the surface we want to put lettering on. Create sketch. Up here in sketch is text. Click text. And we'll zoom in here enough to place our text. Just click somewhere. doesn't really matter. Go up to the box and type what you want to say. Fusion engine. I think that sounds good. And look, we can now drag this around a little bit and position it. We can rotate it if we wanted to, but it's a little on the big side, I think. 3, 7, 5. Yeah, a little better. And you can position it where you want it. There, that's good. You can change your font, bold, italicize. Here, we'll italicize it. And say OK. Do an extrude, select it, and let's make it 50 thousandths. And it's a join, sounds good. And now you got raised letters. All right, now let's paint it up, right? So you can hit A for appearance, and in this top box here, you want to put your palette. So we're going to choose some red. Now, down here, I'll scroll down here. And some blue. And some, okay. Now, there's a lot of stuff here. There's paint, liquid, all sorts of stuff, right? All sorts of options here. Let's go to metal, aluminum. Oh, I must have had it open already. And then I'm going to say polished aluminum. Now this is my palette I'm going to use. So I'm going to select faces first, because there's going to be machined faces, so that's going to be shiny. So we're going to use polished aluminum on that face, on the face inside, the bore, this face. So I'm just going to put polished aluminum on all the faces I'm going to machine. There, inside these bores, once you drill them, they're going to be shiny. And we got some stuff on this side. And we have some stuff on the bottom. Bottom's machined. And the end got machined. And let's see, and the inside of these holes actually were machined. There we go. So there, we did that up. Now it's going to really make it stand out as this is. Now we're going to say bodies, and we're just going to say boom, and we're going to say to the whole body, but we're going to say keep the applied faces that were already done. And now it's blue, it's machined. Now we're going to make the engine letters pop out. And we're going to use red for that. So you want to zoom in to do this. It's so you can select them easily. Go back to faces, I'm sorry. And they're kind of a pain to select sometimes. But the more you zoom in, the easier it is. And then just say close and close. And you can turn off your origin over there and suck all that back up. And you can see how you've built your history for your base. And I think that looks pretty doggone good. Didn't take too long to do. And we have our base. Next will be the cylinder. And I encourage you to practice, and we'll add on our cylinder next in the next video for part 2. So thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Please watch all the 3 videos in this series and for the base and practice. And we'll get on with our fusion engine. Thank you.